Hey guys, today I'm really very excited because I got this beast on my hand, an Asus ROG gaming laptop. So you know, being honest, I purchased this laptop last night, but I have not opened it yet, just because I wanted to make an unboxing video, so I could use it as evidence if in case I have got a faulty one, and also because I wanted to earn some views and subscribers from YouTube. So go and subscribe my channel. And you must be feeling that something is not right here. Did you notice something? Yeah, it's my voiceover to the original video. Because my Redmi Note 7 Pro went total crazy and did not record any audio at all. And I was also dumbass who did not notice until the full unboxing was already done. So before opening the box, let's talk about it for a bit. I had purchased this laptop from ITTI store, which is located at Putali Sadak, Kathmandu, but you can also purchase it from their website. So talking about its price, I had paid ₹1,30,000 for this one. However, its price on their website is 10k more at ₹1,40,000, including the band. So now let's see its specs mentioned in their website. It has i5 9th gen CPU with GTX 1650 graphics card, 8GB of DDR4 RAM and 4GB of video DDR5 RAM, 15.6 inch full HD 1080p IPS LCD display with anti-glare could go up to 144Hz and 500GB of NVMe SSD, and last but not least, 4S 64Wh battery. These were the main features, and other than that, it has RGB over the keyboard and also LED borders all around the bottom side, which looks really awesome. And also they mentioned that this will also include a bag and also a mouse, so we really have to open the box to find out. It is really hard to replicate those expressions in the voiceover, but my excitement at that time is hard to describe in words. Inside the big box, there is another box which in my opinion is a retail piece, and separate compartment which is a backpack. After taking it apart, the box is totally empty now. The quality seems to be promising and design looks really good. This bag is quite small and I think it can carry laptop with some extra accessories, but I don't think you can use this bag to carry your books to the college, so no chance here. Now let's move to the part that we all are waiting for, unboxing the main box. The feeling at that time was out of the world, and at the same time I was also afraid of leaving fingerprints on the laptop. You know, it happens with almost all of us when we purchase new stuff. Let's put it aside and see what else did we get. Okay, inside the box, we have a normal instruction manual, extension cables for adding 2.5 inch SSDs, a wonderful slim and slick adapter with relatively thick AC adapter wires. The adapter also has its logo on it, which also looks cool, and after looking to its level, I found that it was 150 watt adapter. And the last thing that we got is the original Strix Impact mouse, which the seller has mentioned earlier. It has a nice weight into it and also a logo which, as far as I am concerned, should also glow RGB. So now let's see the main thing. After peeling off the plastic protectors, this laptop is going to be powered up for the first time. But first, let's take a look to the ports that we got in this laptop. So this thing has a power input, HDMI and LAN connectors in the back between two headsets. And other than that, it has 3 USB-A ports and 3.5mm headphone jack on the left with one speaker grill, and on the right there are no any ports but another speaker. So this has stereo speakers, but I don't see any USB-C port here. I think the seller should give more attention while writing specification, because the consumer would get misled. Also, they had clearly mentioned that it has 720p webcam, but none of the ROG Strix series laptop has a webcam built into them. So how do we explain this, ITTI store? However, they were kind enough to give me another webcam for free, but they cannot get away with this. They should correct this as soon as possible. And my best suggestion for you is this: search for best laptop online, but only purchase laptop offline by manually testing all the specs, because you never know what you get inside the box. So confirm before you buy.
It looks wonderful from the front too. Has a nice big keyboard and the mouse pad. I almost had a heart attack when I tried powering it up. It gave no any response. In most of the cases, the laptop will power up right when you click the power button, but this was not the case here. I tried several push combinations, but none of them worked. I was too panicked that I was thinking of calling them. And at last, a thought suddenly came into my mind that it might not have enough juice left in the batteries. So I immediately pulled the charger out of the box and connected it before dialing a call to the store. And thankfully this time, when I pressed the power up key, it booted up with red lights all over the keyboard, and I think only then my heartbeat went normal. After the boot up, it almost took me half an hour to set up everything, and it was truly not a pleasant process. I finally landed on my totally empty desktop. I won't be reviewing this laptop because this laptop is already 1 year old, and I'm editing and posting this video more than 3 weeks from the date I purchased it. But I can share my experiences with you.
I am not a pro gamer or anything, but the first thing that I noticed was that the display is slow. It felt nothing more than a standard 60Hz monitor and was nowhere near advertised 144Hz. With the impressions I had with advertised but not existing USB-C port and 720p webcam, I could just pray that this 144Hz claim is not fake. I messaged them source in the internet, and finally after a day I found out that by default the display refresh rate is kept at 60Hz to save some power, and we have to manually set it to 144Hz. A big relief to me, you know. And other than that, talking about my experiences with this laptop, I must say this laptop is smooth and runs cool. I tried running Premiere Pro, Fusion 360, Chrome altogether, and I did not feel any lag in performance, although the laptop in this battery sucks. And when I was using this laptop for video editing, surfing web or using Fusion, it was plugged in most of the time, like 80% of the time. However, I am fully satisfied with this laptop and could certainly recommend this to anyone if battery drain is not a big issue for them. I am planning for the craziest project that I have ever done till now when I reach 1k subscribers, so please subscribe. The person who guesses this right in the comment will get shout out in that particular video. And thank you my patron Mr. Ben Rees for your support. See you in another video, stay safe and stay happy.